The offensive operations to take back territory from the Federation has been going well with your continued support, Sicario. Your air support up and down the front has been integral in demoralizing and outright destroying enemy air superiority. All this, however, has forced the Federation to respond in overwhelming force. Our intelligence has obtained a crucial piece of information on the deployment of the Federation's main airship fleet, Task Force One. Task Force One's deployment to Cascadia would be overwhelming and costly to the Independence Force. A direct confrontation would be nothing less than a disaster. Thankfully for us, they're not yet in the country and are on the last leg of their journey. In the Pacific, the Kingdom of Saweki is an associate nation of the Federation, much like how Cascadia was before the war. Their islands are rich in natural resources and therefore an economic hub in the middle of the Pacific. Because of this, the main Federation harbor for airships on this side of the globe rests there. The plan is this. Sicario will lead an air assault of mercenaries in, taking out the airship fleet while they're in port. We're devoting every single aerial tanker we have in order for you to reach out there. Hitman team, you'll be on point with Sicario. The port and the surrounding area is entirely a militarized industrial sector, all meant for maintaining the airship fleet and, on a lesser note, the naval forces of the Federation. This is a target-rich environment, and we expect nothing less than total dismantling of the Federation's infrastructure and force deployment capability in the entire Pacific. We're unsure on how the Kingdom of Saweki will respond, but be on the lookout for their local air force. Some nations in alliance with the Federation might not see it our way. News outlets throughout the world have stated the obvious. Task Force One has been crippled in port. Lone airships remain in the region, but none with the combat experience or firepower as the Federation's main pride. Defensive positions held by the Federation banking on their arrival have quickly folded, and the snowball effect has begun. The war is going our way, thanks to you. The Kingdom of Sawinki has kept quiet regarding this, but collateral damage to Throne facilities were kept to a minimum. What damage they did sustain, they blamed the Federation for not maintaining a proper defense, despite what the Sawinki people have offered them. No matter the cost, however, this is a massive blow to the Federation that they can't possibly recover from.